I'm Laureate Professor Eric Reynolds at the Melbourne Dental School, the University of Melbourne. In Australia, the economic impact of oral disease, which is largely tooth decay and gum disease, is $8 billion a year. Worldwide, it's $400 billion a year. So it's a huge burden on society. Early in my career as a young dental academic, we were looking at the nutritional effects on tooth decay. And there was anecdotal and epidemiological evidence that dairy products could reduce the risk of tooth decay, but it needed a more rigorous scientific approach. So we started experiments to see if dairy products like milk and cheese could in fact lower the risk of tooth decay. There was a unique form of calcium that was very bioavailable, and it was made that way by specific proteins in milk. We actually could isolate those and then deliver those in pure form and in concentrated form to show that we could strengthen tooth enamel and make it more resistant to tooth decay. I was given good advice by colleagues to patent the discovery through the University of Melbourne, and then we got interest from overseas companies that wanted samples to evaluate. The technology now in all of its forms is now available in over 50 countries worldwide. The most successful country is Japan, where it's the number one sugar-free gum. You can calculate the impact in terms of the benefit of the technology in reducing dental treatments. And the calculations that have been put forward in terms of the economic impact of this technology over quite a long period is around $12 billion in savings. It's incredibly satisfying to look back over a career that's taken 30 years to develop, to now know that millions of people are using the technology that we've been involved with, and it is having a major impact on lowering this economic but also the social burden of oral diseases, and therefore improving the quality of life.